Hi, my name is Dennis Woodruff. I'd like to take you on an adventure. This documentary film is about graffiti artists. We're right here in West Hollywood, and I'd like to take you on this journey and let you and everyone else discover for yourself this wonderful art form that has emerged. It's now 2008. I don't know how long it's been going on, but it's worth people taking a second notice. Being that I've been an artist all my life, I've always enjoyed making art, being creative, and enjoyed meeting other people who are creative like me and original. I'd like to show you this art, this mural art that is emerging all over Los Angeles as we speak, and it has been for some time. These artists are trying to get their work seen, and the canvas they use is the streets. They're not hurting anyone, they're not gang members. Sure, there's good and bad in every situation, but this is a very positive art form that really should be in galleries and hanging on your living room wall, on canvases, and given some proper attention. So let me now take you on this adventure, on this journey of graffiti art. One thing I find that's incredible about this art form is that as it deteriorates, it gets scraped up and scratched, then all of a sudden a new mural appears out of nowhere. And nobody really knows who it is, because a lot of these works of art aren't even signed. The Picasso that did this didn't even put his name on it. Can you believe it? Yes, it's true. My work on my cars is my own expression of graffiti art. But mine moves around the city. But that doesn't make it more valid than anyone else's. It's just the way the artist chooses to do their art. Their collaging, their spray paint, the colors they choose. It's all a symbol of what they believe in and what they must express about their individuality and creativity. What's so pure about this art form is it doesn't have to be better one from the other. It's all beautiful and it's all good. These people should be in museums with their art. Do you agree? What I'm about to do is take you on a tour of the alleyways and the art canvases and museum of the Melrose back alleys, where the real fine artists hang out and hide out at night and paint their beautiful murals. Oh, it's so wonderful, don't you think? Do we choose to be artists, or are we just born that way and we can't escape it? We must express our individuality, and where does it come from? Deep in our soul. We must express it. Nobody knows how the imagination works. It just does, and we must accept it and appreciate it. Some people paint over it and then they come back later and paint over it again. It's really sad that people are destroying this art. Sadder that they're destroying it and great that they're creating it.
I'm not that other guy, Dennis Woodruff. I'm out here, I'm a private eye, and I'm gonna get all those taggers. This is a news alert, and I want all of you out there to roam the streets, drive around in your cars, and let us know if you can find these graffiti artists. They must be stopped. We're gonna get them. or my name isn't Finkel. Get him. Gary Finkel, I'm your man. You elected me as your main detective in Hollywood to stop this graffiti. And I plan on getting to the bottom of this and taking all of them and just taking them down to San Diego and dropping them off in the bus or put them in jail where they belong. Or my name isn't Harry Finkel. You can count on me. I'm your man. It's Harry.
Do you get mad at people for painting the building?
No, we asked them to. They're actually our resident artists who work with us.
I think it's great. Isn't it a true work of art?
No, it really is. That one's Retina, and he actually works with the store that is in that building, which is called Got Hose.
Uh-huh.
All right, bye.
Every wall in the city becomes a canvas for the artist to explore. Every square, every small rectangle becomes a canvas ready to be adorned by artists everywhere with their art for us to enjoy. One thing I noticed about art and artists, we're all the same and different and original and creative, and that's what's important. We're all making our own individual statement with our art. In every aspect of the moment we touch the canvas, which could be anything, a wall, a car, it becomes our own. We own it. And it has a life after we leave. we think about the artists and how they need to tell their story. We need more self-expression and art in our world. I can't think of how important it is. And artists want to be appreciated for their talent. Graffiti art is a wonderful thing for all ages to explore. Who pays for all this paint? The hours spent, the dedication to an art form which is emerging for us to enjoy in our cities throughout the world. I urge you to be supportive of these artists and find a way to comfort them and pay them and decorate our homes with their art. Even if we only put one piece, they're just as good as any other work of art that we've ever heard about throughout art history. As art history takes on its own new meanings, the artists will explore their canvases wherever they can find them. They could even be on a train, an alleyway, a billboard, an empty wall. And hopefully we will appreciate them. And we will appreciate their art, their works of art. Whenever I've gone to a museum of modern art or abstract art, I see people standing around wondering what it all means, trying to figure it out. And I talked to one person and they said, oh, that looks like a lake. And another said it looked like a bird. And another said it looked like a stream with fish flowing through. So art can be whatever we want it to be. It can be a pleasant place to grow in our mind and enjoy the tranquility for the moment. To go into the subconscious mind and explore a deeper meaning and concentrate on our emotions. I become very emotional at times when I see art. It really moves me, and other times it leaves me speechless. But I know the artist intended either negative or positive to create a response. So as we notice the empty walls in life, we hope that the artist will come and fill them up with beauty and splendor for our eyes to enjoy. What do you think about this graffiti art?
I love it.
Huh?
I love it.
Isn't it beautiful?
Oh, yeah.
What's your favorite?
All the stuff by CBS.
Yeah. Have you seen them around? When do they do this?
Months ago.
This is making a movie about graffiti art.
Nice, bro.
When do they do this? Late at night?
They do it during the stealth hours, yes.
Boy, it's wonderful to come to work and see all this great art as it changes
like,
too, doesn't it?
Exactly. Meeting people like you, who we've had history with.
Uh-huh. Yeah, man. Okay, we'll see you, man.
Icons of Los Angeles.
Right.
Dennis,
on.
Dennis Woodruff.
You rock, guys.
That's right,
have you seen my latest movie I gave you?
Bro, you know what?
Sold you one for $20.
You sold me one in the Silver Lake too.
Have you seen my latest movie yet? Remember?
I haven't had time to watch any movies, man.
Okay, but you're going to.
I'm going to.
Exactly.
Famous skateboarder here. What's your name?
Ian.
Ian what?
Macdonald.
And your name, sir?
Rudolfo Vasquez.
Right on. You rock, man.
Thank you, sir.
Even a little one means a lot. Not just a big one, but a little one makes a statement.
LA Graffiti that's available at, next door at Suru. Some of the same artists from the 80s are still the same artists today. Valid and refusing. Richie Art of Lutenberg, don't forget it.
Juan Vasquez, don't forget it.
Thank you, sir.
Yeah, buddy.
Dennis Woodruff.
Right. DennisWoodruffShow.com. Hi, what's your name?
Robbie.
Robbie, what are you doing?
Just cleaning the building up. You know, people make a mess here. Some people like to put graffiti on it. Some just make it dirty. So, well, I come back every week and clean up the graffiti here on this building. So,
would you consider it works of art or vandalism?
Some of it's pretty amazing. I've had to erase some really nice works, but I take photographs of those ones, you know. But for the most part, it's just people just making a mess on the wall.
So in reality, you work for the man, the establishment. But the other side of the coin is that you really love artists, and you like this art, and you save it. Is that correct?
Yeah. Well, I mean, you know. Some of these people that do the art, they're pretty good artists. You can't say that they're not, because some of their work that goes up on the wall is nice to look at, you know. But I have to keep a building clean.
What do you use to get this stuff off with this rag?
Just water on a rag.
Uh-huh, and then you paint over it with this gray paint?
I use the paint over it. No.
Does the owner of this building get kind of irritated when he sees graffiti on the walls and stuff?
Well, let's put it this way. The people who rent this building from the owner obviously pay a lot of money to rent it. You know, they have a nice business going on inside there, and they want to keep it clean. A couple of years ago when I came here, this building was a complete mess. I mean, there was graffiti everywhere. I won't go into everything else that was lying around here, and you know, so we just wanted to clean it up and keep it that way.
Okay,
so,
well,
there you go.
There you go. That's it. You even have graffiti on your t-shirt. I'm Dennis Woodruff. I'm a guerrilla filmmaker.
I've seen your cards ever since I arrived here in America in 1986.
Well, see my work, my website, Dennis Woodruff Show. See my films. I'm the filmmaker.
Yeah?
You like them?
I liked it, yeah.
Well,
cool.
Keep watching my website and you'll see all my films. Making
like
new ones
films.
All the time.
I'm not sure if I like your cars better, but you know, you're always driving some crazy car.
Hi, it's me again, Dennis Woodruff. We're going to continue our tour now. We're going down around, we're probably going to end up down on Gower, and we're going to see some trippy stuff. There's a lot of graffiti art everywhere, but I'm trying to pick the areas that are the best for you. This is Dennis Woodruff, your faithful narrator for graffiti art. We're out here in Hollywood, and I'm getting the great graffiti artists of our community. I hope you enjoy this, and I'm trying to frame this. Hi, it's me, Dennis Woodruff. I'm out in Hollywood. We're going to hit Gower and see if we can get some more graffiti art. It's pretty amazing, some of the stuff I'm finding. I hope you're getting excited about this art form, and let me know what you think. Chicano power, man! Chicano power! Right on, man! What do you think about this graffiti art? The heritage of graffiti art and Latino art?
People should see more of it, man. This is art that the Latinos came up with, man. It's an art that's out there that based a lot of people put so much into it, so much effort into it. It's beautiful. I used to graffiti myself when I was younger. I mean, this didn't help pay the bills. I mean, this is a new wave. It's gonna do a lot for us.
Do you think that they should be prosecuted?
No, they shouldn't be. They shouldn't be. It's art. If you look, it's paint. Same thing as a real artist gets their own paint. They have their own utensil. They have the way how to do it. I mean, look, it's up here for a reason. They gave somebody permission to do it for it. Did I used to get in trouble? Yeah, I used to get in trouble a lot.
What happened?
Guy went to jail.
How long?
A couple months. It was always in and out.
But, for what?
For well, getting
caught on. What was the charges? Vandalism?
Vandalism, defacing property. It's a lot of stuff, man. You go through it, but it's just the adrenaline rush you get from it. It's beautiful, man. You just love doing it. You want to keep doing it. I did it for years.
Did you do it at nighttime?
Maybe at night, day, anytime.
You'd be doing a beautiful mural and
anything. Murals, bombs, tags, anything.
And then when the cops roll up, what do they say? You're under arrest?
Yeah, I mean, it's up to you. Even if the cops come through, I would go ahead and finish my stuff. It doesn't matter. You did it up there for a reason. It's all up to you.
I think we have to fight society's rules.
Yeah, we should. Get a petition out there. Legalize it. Why not?
What's your name?
My name? Call me Los.
Homie?
Call me Los.
Cool. Well, thank you for talking to me. I'm Dennis Woodruff. I'm a guerrilla filmmaker, and I'm going around the streets, and I'm documenting this wonderful work of art.
Yeah. It's beautiful, man. Beautiful.
Okay, thanks. Yeah.
There should be more of it.
Yeah,
take
right
care,
on.
Boss.
Okay, later.
Yeah.
To you, one thing, if you leave your truck or van around long enough, it's going to get tagged. And it might even turn into a beautiful work of art or a unbelievable tag job. I'll be honest though, I think it's kind of rude to put a tag right on the windshield. I've had that done. I've actually had my cars tagged a few times. And come on man, don't put it on the windshield. What happened to your truck? It's all graffitied out.
Good with the picture, not the film it, man.
Yeah, well, let me just get a shot of your van. Pretty unbelievable.
Right?
It's un- unbelievable. You leave your car parked somewhere, your truck, it just gets a total graffiti job. But it's cool. It's all good. Woodruff, I do want to acknowledge the fact that there should be some regulation to the fact of artists, you know, something I didn't realize is that some of these artists aren't getting permission. They're just putting up their billboards. I really think that I've talked to some of the landowners off the alleys and stuff, and some of them, they say, oh, this is a terrible looking alley. It looks terrible. And they've come here and they've decorated their, you know, our walls with their graffiti and their graffiti art, and we really like it. And then there are some that didn't like it. So I'm not taking a stand one way or the other about the legalities. I'm just pointing out the beauty of the art. Definitely, I don't go around tagging or, you know, think it's funny to vandalize people's property. I've never done it myself. I'm all for not breaking the law, but I do believe that we should look into the possibility of letting them have certain areas in the city that they can display their art. And I think their art is valid, and I think they're probably frustrated that people don't see it that way. I've talked to a few that say they've been prosecuted for their artwork. I don't in any way support any form of vandalism or breaking the law. And I would urge all of you out there who examine this art form to realize that, you know, there should be certain regulation as to where it can be done. And I think the positive outweighs the negative. I've talked to people and some don't like it and some do. But, you know, I think they need a certain place to do it. I do my cars, and I've been doing it for years, but I don't do other people's cars. If you see my name on my car, that's mine. That's my signature. But I don't go around and, you know, spray paint on other people's cars. So that's all I wanted to say about that is, I'm not allocated, you know, I'm not saying that people should go out and vandalize other people's property, you know, cars without their permission or whatever. I think there should be a way to get this to where we can have this beautiful artwork in certain areas of the city, and the city could appreciate that. And I don't really think that these people should be put in jail. I think that they should be, we should have certain regulations to make areas that they can. I'm pretty sure these are good people. A lot of them I talked to didn't want to go on camera, but I'm a good guy, I'm an artist, and I think artists, most of us, we don't want to hurt anyone, we just want to do our art. So I think that's what it's all about, is working together to have a better world so we can all express our individuality, our creativity. And especially one last thing I want to say is art in our society is diminishing every year, the interest in art. And that's because people are very materialistic and they're getting involved in other things. There is no value anymore on art. Paintings aren't really worth anything except famous paintings like Picasso or Rembrandt or Monet or Degas. But today there's a new art form that's emerging from our youths that is worth looking into. And I think there's a lot of positive things to say about this art form. And I personally am very excited about it. Pretty naive as far as the legalities and the illegal part of it, but I'd say, you know, do anything you can to make the world a better place, just don't break the law. Okay.
As far as I know, no one really pointless to complain when this is going to get tagged over. My name is Dylan Abuel. I'm an MC, complete hip-hop head, and I love graffiti. But I'm documenting all this and, you know, trying to show off to my friends in Germany. But anyway, what I think about this, this is art for the street. This is art for, like, this is untapped art. Real, like, there's a lot of risk that comes along with this art, and the artists who take it, I mean, look at this, for real. There's no way to describe this stuff. I mean, if you don't get it, you don't get it, but if you do, then you love it.
Art has become a part of our contemporary society. Art is everywhere, it should be. I just spoke to a LAPD officer and he said anybody getting caught putting art on walls, if the property owner wants to prosecute, any damage over $400 is a misdemeanor, under $400, and anything above that is a felony, and the person can be put in jail and charged for the crime, whatever damage, to replace back into a normal building. Some people have permission and those will not be prosecuted. It seems a little bit ridiculous, However, we must respect each other's property. The LAPD officer would not go on camera, but he did tell me that it is a felony, any damage on a building without permission over $400. The person can be prosecuted and put in jail for up to a year or more, and it is a felony. I believe that we have to find out places where people can do this legally and they won't be prosecuted for being an artist.
And I think graffiti like that is an art, and some of the others that came to do that, that was like about a half a year ago, and they're very professional. Most of the guys are little kids, you know. So if they graffiti and they do decent art, that would be better for the city. Because it looks beautiful from here, you know. And that's what I have to say about that, you know.
Well, the police told me it's a felony if they don't get permission, anything over $400. Did you give them permission?
Of course. The shop owner given permission to do that because they were graffitiing before. You know, just put barrio letters and numbers. So, you know, we talked to them and they came, they're willing to do the art. And look what it became of it.
Beautiful. Nice, beautiful. Beautiful, yeah.
So, you know, we think it's better like that. If you give me permission to do something better with the city, instead of just, you know, write it on the wall, whatever it is. And a lot of Latino artists, you know, some of them gang related and they graffiti the streets. But I think if they really, really understand what art is, they, you know, they will learn to do it in the right place.
But wait a minute. I don't want to judge them with my documentary and say one is good and one is bad. I think all of us, no matter where you come from, have a right to have your art shown to the world. It doesn't matter, you know, where you came from. If you came from the worst ghetto in the world, you still deserve a chance. Do you agree
I think
or not?
So. Yeah, I agree, definitely.
You can't label some people good and some people bad. You know, I mean, they're all trying to express their art. At least that's my opinion.
Of course, I'm the same opinion. I mean, art is art, you know, and that's the way. We should give them a chance. Like we did with these kids, you know, and it looks beautiful. So everybody should have a chance to do an art. If they, you know, they know how to do it, they will express themselves like that, give him a chance, you know. Anybody can give him a chance.
Wow. What do you think of graffiti art?
Oh, graffiti art? Oh, Sonny? Sonny's a great guy. You see them lately? He can get killed, did he? I mean, like, I saw him go by in his car with this lady, you know.
He's my friend.
I haven't seen Sonny in a long time. When last time you seen Sonny?
Do you like graffiti art, sir?
Graffiti art? I'm of a tipster type.
You what?
John? I'm of the John type. It's not graffiti.
But
that's not either. I don't know.
Do you like graffiti art?
Well,
does it have a place? Does it have a place in our society?
Graffiti? No.
Why not?
Because sometimes it's not medicine. It's not doctor prescribed.
As the day goes by, time passes, and we see the beautiful art of the world, and I can't help but want to film it. As I film it, I am more and more inspired every minute. I am the roaming filmmaker Dennis Woodruff. I must capture the true beauty and art of the world as it transcends from sundown to sunbreak. As the sun sets and sun rises, day to day, I must capture the imagery that I see, the beauty in our world. And on I go. Sometimes you have to hike a long ways up in the mountains to find that perfect graffiti art. I know I've been hiking now for about an hour to find this work of art I heard about. Check it out. It.
This is the one I was looking for. Isn't this something else? This is amazing. Can you imagine? Somebody did this. This is unbelievable. Well, it's me, Dennis Woodruff, and we're just about at the end of our journey. We've explored the streets and the city of Hollywood in LA with the graffiti art and artists. I'm standing in front of one of my favorite pieces, the Lonely Dragon. This is where the skateboarders hang out, and they skateboard up and down this gully, and I hope he doesn't eat them. Well, I'll see ya, and thanks for supporting Guerrilla Filmmaking and Dennis Woodruff Films. Can you imagine? I think they should let all the top graffiti artists give them all the paint they want and ladders and go up. Can you visualize the Hollywood sign all graffitied out? Wouldn't that look unbelievable? Total graffiti art on all the letters of the Hollywood sign. Now that would be a positive statement in Hollywood. God bless America, land that I love. Stand beside her and guide her through the rain and the snow and the graffiti artists and the earthquakes. Everybody! This has been a Tuffy Productions film directed by Dennis Woodruff. All right, Tuffy!